Professor, I've just been all over the world. I've been to incredibly hot climates and the Arctic. I've had lots of beers in all of the different environments around the world.
Yeah, okay. Yes?
Just flown back into town, and on the plane, my brain was just spinning in alcohol and thoughts. It hurt.
Understood.
And I was thinking about, sometimes beer gets really hot. And then, in the Arctic, it's always frozen. Only have cold beer. Yeah. Sometimes it's too cold. You can hardly drink it.
Yeah, that's not good.
I was wondering, with many experiments that you've conducted over the years,
yes,
if this would affect the taste of beer.
Let's test this theory. Beers exposed at different temperatures, do they taste different? Do the molecular structures break down in the beer? I want to know. Let's run some tests and find out. Stick around.
Yes, science!
Beer science! Lagers, porters, and Belgians, triple builders, and IPAs, my friend, we're making beer science! Sours, browns, and double bumps, and those reds and blots, Hellas, Kolsch, and Irish stouts, beer science! Beer science!
Polly, welcome back to another episode of Beer Science. Today, we are learning about the effects of temperature on beer. We performed testing on three different stages. We have a beer chilled from birth, we have a beer subjected to room temperature, and we have a beer exposed to high temperature. We then chilled those beers after a week-long study, and we are now going to blind taste of those beers to see if we can tell the difference in their molecular structure. What do you think?
Professor, very detailed experiments. Thank I would you. Agree that this is a well-designed experiment with a great control.
It's very good.
Yes.
You're right there?
Yes, I just had a experiment moment.
You've been drinking backstage. Now, I'll remind you, we are professionals. Please do not try this at home.
They can try this at home. It's legal.
Oh, it's legal? Mm. You okay. Depending on your state's legislature, you may continue at home, if legal, by your governor. If not legal, please proceed with caution. Please do not alert the authorities. Now,
I believe this is illegal in Pennsylvania.
If you are 21 or older, please proceed with caution. If you are 21 or younger, please don't watch this. Turn it off.
No, watch this.
Learn something about science. They don't teach you this in school. They don't teach you this in science class, but we're here to teach you something important, and that's science! Now I'm ready to proceed with the next experiment. What is it? Is that your introduce?
It says it's beer science for those with needs of beer.
Now, there's many in the world who need beer. We're here to help share in that need by providing scientific explanations of the best way to beer. My assistant will now proceed to retrieve the beers from the cooling chamber. Here he comes now.
I have refrained from reading your cryptic messages on the cans.
Thank you.
To keep this a blind, controlled experiment.
Now, these beers, I've written on the bottom of these cans, an R for room temperature, a C for cold, and an H for hot. Those are the identifying symbols.
Close your eyes. I will show the participants the messages, the cryptic
messages.
Please go ahead.
Please proceed to randomize the subjects. Before us, we have three beverages of different contrasting environmental strenuous changes and potentially subjected to various conditions.
Yes.
Shall we? Now, we chose New Belgium's 1985 IPA because we wanted a beer with a little substance, a little flavor profile that we can maybe distinguish the different characteristics.
I believe that this is also a very cool can.
Okay. The beers have all been but poured, and now they're ready for the scientific examination. Let's share in these beverages, shall we?
Professor.
Shall we start to my left?
We shall start to your left. And in this methodology, I believe one of the terms they use is a blind taste test, so I would prefer if you close your eyes while you drink. Thank you.
Is that necessary?
Professor, yes, it's very necessary. It's in the name.
As you recommend. My eyes are closed. I am now drinking.
That's pretty good.
It's pretty good.
It's kind of like a fruit roll-up, if I have to say so myself.
I taste nothing of a substance that is bad. I taste very good beer.
Mm-hmm. Let me try.
Let's go back in for another taste.
So I, as a base, I do not detect any funkadocious tributes to this.
None whatsoever.
A custom-made beverage.
Based on first sample, I would say this may be the cold beverage. What do you think?
I'm not ready to deduce any conclusions, Professor.
Nor should you.
I'm ready to attempt another comparison.
Let's move on to the second beverage. What say you?
Professor, I believe that is a wonderful idea that you concocted here in this beer laboratory.
Absolutely.
Eyes closed, please.
Closing of the eyes begins, and cheers.
It has a different flavor.
It does.
It really does.
What would you describe that as?
It's not as vibrant.
It's almost sour.
It's not vibrant as the other beer. I'm surprised.
I taste more hops.
The sweetness is less.
Yeah, exactly. The sugar has been reduced to a more bitterness. I'm tasting more hoppiness. And yes, the sweetness of the first sample
dwindled.
Has dwindled.
Aggressively.
Aggressively, absolutely. Mm. Interesting.
Science is a very detailed and interesting subject. We do not recommend that you attempt scientific inquiries like these as advanced as we have done today.
Science is a motherfucker.
It's a textbook example.
I don't write. I didn't write them.
You wrote some of them.
I've studied them. I've wrote many, actually.
But not this one.
No, not this science.
Not the other science.
Anyway.
Don't bore our listeners. They don't.
You wouldn't understand.
You fucking idiots.
The symmetry is very upsetting.
Shit.
Why don't you love science? I can see it on your face. You're making fun of us. Do you think you're more scientific than us? You're not. Let's proceed with subject three, shall we?
Professor?
Beers and cheers and science to you, buddy.
It's close.
Boy.
This one tastes fizzier.
A little more effervescent.
Effervescent.
It's a little sweeter, like subject one.
Please test around the edges with the mustachular.
The flavor saver?
Yes. No, with the scientific term is the vehicular testosterator.
The vehicular testosterator. I'm gonna make sure I give it a goose wish.
Very scientific.
You really want it to permeate the
vesicles.
The vesicles and the pores of your mouth.
The porous vesicles.
Okay. I'm gonna go back in for two. Let's taste two again. Subject two.
It's flatter and a hot
that
beer.
That one I don't like the most.
Yeah, that's the worst one.
That one tastes the worst.
In scientific terms, that's the shittiest boy.
This one has a piercing flavor.
It's like shit.
It's not good. I would say subject one and subject three taste the best. Subject two really tastes not great.
Well, I took a thorough analysis of subject one. Mm-hmm. So, Professor, are you ready to give your final analysis on what you believe to be the case of...
Yes, absolutely, Paulie. My hypotenuse is that subject two is the hot beer.
That was also going to be my hypothetical philosophical exploration.
As it should be, because it definitely tastes the worst. Therefore, I believe it was subjected to the most heat, which in turn changed the molecular structure of the beverage and made it shitty.
As we would say, it's a hot boy.
It's a hot boy.
It's a hot boy.
You ever get a beer and it's not good? Probably because of that.
It's a hot boy.
All right, let's move on. We've determined, as we believe, this to be the hot beer. Now, what do you think the room temperature beer might be? I am compelled to agree with you, sir. This beer felt the second best in terms of flavor. This beer tasted like it might have been affected
in
some kind of environmental subsidiary. Catastrophe. Yes, absolutely. Let me go ahead and drink it again.
Yes, yes.
It's not bad. It's quite good, actually. I need to compare once again to subject one, shall we?
Yes, yes, yes.
I feel like it's still better.
Yes.
All right.
So that would leave the deduction to be that subject one is the continually chilled fresh beer.
I would deduce that subject one was chilled from birth, meaning I bought this beer cooled and it stayed cooled until we drank it just now.
Professor, I think we should reveal our findings and see if we are accurate.
All right.
Please. 3, 2, 1.
Interesting.
I can't tell what that says.
I am perplexed right now.
The hot beer was better.
The hot beer. What the hell? What the hell?
Fuck!
My life is a lie.
So,
Polly, hold on. Are you seeing this? What the Christ? No, it's impossible. Cold was the worst one. It doesn't make any fucking sense!
Science is a lie!
I denounce science in all forms. It's wrong!
Fuck you, science!
It's secular and wrong!
And they hate facts!
Alright, to recap, the tastiest beer was the beer exposed to hot temperatures.
Professor, I think after we've cooled down, we've learned that the way to have the best tasting beer is to get it really hot.
Apparently that makes it better somehow. At least as far as we're concerned.
Science.
This doesn't make sense.
Science is a finicky.
It's a cyclical bitch.
It's a finicky lover.
What is this one again? Room temp. What? Was that good?
It was okay.
Let me try it again. What's fucked up is the beer that was kept at the coldest temperature was the nastiest tasting one to our palates.
Voodoo Ranger, please.
Please advise.
Please send us a scientific explanation.
A beer exposed at high radiation was delicious, and a beer left at room temperature was still pretty good. Mm.
Science is a finicky mistress. That's what they say.
That's what I heard. Mm. Science is a finicky mistress.
On that note, thank you everybody for studying with us here at Beer Science.
We hope you learned a lot. We hope you took some notes, because we are going to quiz you on it on the next episode of Beer Science, so stick around. Until then, stay learned, stay smart, and stay scientific. Stay drunk! Right? Tell him, Paulie. Tell him.
Stay drunk.
Science!